face the light that's ahead of me. On board, I'm your tour guide. Welcome aboard. We'll search for tomorrow.
Galing ano?
To be quiet because we're too up to be your best friend. No, I'm not a real estate agent. Right now we're passing by the 9/11 memorial. You'll be able to see the tallest building on the site right now. One World Trade, 105 stories tall, 1,776 feet. It's known as the Freedom Tower because of the symbolic height of the building, 1776 being the... And whenever you see a flower put through the name on the site, you know it's that individual's birthday. The 9/11 Memorial, you might have seen it, but you probably didn't know that. Right now, we're getting to the southernmost neighborhoods of New York City, a neighborhood right next to Battery Park, known as Battery Park City. You'll see on the left. We'll see some more of that right a little bit later on. Right about now, we're going past the section of New Jersey known as the Gold Coast because of this building right next to the Colgate Clock. It's known as the Goldman Sachs World Banking Tower. They moved out to New Jersey after the 2001 tragedies in the former home of the Colgate Toothpaste Factory. Also used to be home of the Palmolive Soap Company. Right next door to a great place where you guys can get boats, jet ski rentals, the marina in New Jersey. You got a lot of great things in our brother state right here, the Garden State. 41 state parks. Truly the Garden State. A lot of lush greenery in New Jersey. Speaking of that, you have Liberty State Park. Liberty State Park is Dumbo. It's not north of Houston, it's NoHo. It's not south of Houston, it's SoHo. It's not hop on, hop off buses, they're ho-hos. I just wanted to see if you're listening. I just made that up. But the concept of enlightenment. Come on now, it's not raining. Don't be scared.
Yeah, don't be scared.
Mother Nature is allowing you guys to get this moment without being poured on.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mother Nature.
Thank you.
Come out and get some fresh air. It's stuffy in there. The Statue of Liberty has a torch in her right hand representing
Liberty.
Okay. Got it. Take these moments to get some photographs with your friends and family, your loved ones, and we're going to...
No, I got you.
Pull me back to that McDonald's. Took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off white Lexus. Driving so slow, BK is from Texas. Me, I'm up that Bed-Stuy, home of that boy Vicky. Now I live on Billboard.
onto Governor's Island. And you also have the Staten Island Ferry Terminal right next door, where you can travel to the least populated borough in all five for free.
Oh.
Go down to Battery Park to ride on the big orange boat famously seen in Spider-Man Homecoming, starring Tom Holland and Michael Keaton. And you can go to the new Empire Outlets, do some shopping, and do some saving at the new outlet malls that are in Staten Island. Were you thinking of going to Woodbury Common? Were you thinking of going to another place besides one of the five boroughs? Tisk, tisk, tisk. You've got everything you need right in the five boroughs. You can go to the outlet malls in Staten Island. You can go on out to Brooklyn, walk the Brooklyn Bridge. You can go on out to the Brooklyn Promenade and get great views of the New York City skyline. You can get a helicopter ride right here from Pier 6. 30-minute tours, bird's eye view over New York City. All it costs you is $350 per person. That means $700 for you and me. The center of New York City commerce, home of the New York Stock Exchange. We're now about to cross over Wall Street. Home to Federal Hall, where the first president of the United States of America was inaugurated in 1789. George Washington was inaugurated right here on Wall Street. See where this book is? You walk down Wall Street, you can also see Trinity Church. Trinity Church is so old, the man depicted on the U.S. $10 bill rests inside of the cemetery. Alexander Hamilton rests inside the grave sites of Trinity Church. You can now see Trinity Church if you look down Wall Street.
Oh, yeah, there.
The Brooklyn Bridge was designed by German American engineer John Augustus Roebling in 1869. Unfortunately, he never got to see the completion of his design. His design was released in June. By July, he would pass away. A supply boat that was bringing in supplies crashed on his leg, and his foot became infected with tetanus in a time before antibiotics. So he passes away and leaves his apprentice, Washington, his son, in control of the completion of the bridge. He was 32 years old when he took over from his father. And in 1872, you see on the port side, you have a pillar that's in the East River. He was surveying underneath the bridge because a lot of men were becoming sick on the staff. And they were wondering why. They were calling it the Brooklyn Bridge disease. Today, they call it decompression sickness. When nitrogen bubbles form in your blood, when you go into such depths, when pressure starts to build in your bloodstream, the symptoms are nausea, vomiting, and then eventually you can become paralyzed. They call that decompression sickness also at that time the bends, because it debilitates you and bends your body up. He was physically bedridden and could only depend on one person to complete the task of having the Brooklyn Bridge unify Manhattan and Brooklyn, which were operating as two separate cities at the time. You know the expression, behind every good man there's a...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, always.
Emily Warren Roebling in 1872 becomes the new chief engineer for 11 years. She becomes the first person to make their way over the Brooklyn Bridge when it's completed with the president, Grover Cleveland, May 24th, 1883. We're now just about less than 10 days away from the Brooklyn Bridge's birthday. In 1884, because not many people were using the Brooklyn Bridge because they were scared that it wasn't going to be strong enough for the intended weight, they needed some kind of way to build publicity for the bridge to be used because not many people were using it. Emily Warren Roebling wrote a letter to Phineas Taylor Barnum, better known by his showman name, P.T. Barnum, and would ask if he could have an elephant go across this bridge to prove that it was strong enough to withstand the intended weights. To prove all the non-believers wrong, he would have 21 elephants walk across the Brooklyn Bridge, led by Jumbo, the African elephant, going from Manhattan to Brooklyn, also camels and menagerie of animals. And the Brooklyn Bridge becomes legendary. Once upon a time, someone tried to sell the Brooklyn Bridge. Oh yeah. There's all types of crazy things that happen in New York. Now, you can easily take a stroll down the Brooklyn Bridge without being swarmed by the vendors being there. They'll have the I Love New York t-shirts and all the souvenirs that you can easily buy in many other places of New York on the Brooklyn Bridge in the past. But now, they are forbidden from being there. So you can easily walk along the Brooklyn Bridge without being bothered by anyone. You'll see the South Street Seaport Pier 17. On the starboard section, you'll be able to see a new structure that opened up in 2018. In 2012, the original South Street Seaport was destroyed from Superstorm Sandy. The Staten Island boat, that's what you want to get on to go shopping. As soon as you get off of the boat, there's a mall. That's where Captain Ryan is from. It has a lot of Italian population in Staten Island, so they got a lot of great pasta and pizza places. If you're looking for something to eat in Staten Island, the pizza sometimes can be better than places in Manhattan there. There are a lot of great places to eat in the five boroughs. There are over 300,000 restaurants. So how do you know that you're making a good God doesn't swim? And find I'm king of the world. Top of the